Love is the language we all understand, no matter if you're close or in a foreign land. It's boundless, no borders, no walls to confine. This podcast is a tale that will definitely blow your mind. Two strangers, a twist of fate down under, moved to Melbourne, a land of all the wonder. They crossed paths as roommates, the vibe was sweet, and built something so strong that's felt in every heartbeat.
Hello, I am Oisin van Leer. I'm an exchange student from the Netherlands.
My name is Nia. I'm on exchange in Australia.
And how many people do you live with?
I live with five other people, so we're six.
And what was your first impression when you met this boy? Like the first experience?
I needed Wi-Fi and mine didn't work, so I asked him for that.
She had a really friendly appearance.
So how did you guys become better friends and become more comfortable within the first month of living together?
We started doing things just the two of us because others from the flat couldn't.
Always when we had conversations, like, we really clicked with each other.
At the beginning it was friendly. I liked like the fact that he's really calm.
Yeah, in the beginning it was just a friend. I always, when I spoke to her, like, really genuinely interested in what I was talking about, and I felt really comfortable with her. She was like really scared in the area of the flying foxes, and I thought it was pretty cute. I felt like from then on started to like her, and I kind of felt she did as well.
When I started to be like, okay, maybe there's a bit more, I was kind of looking forward to have moments with him. Yeah, and when I started to think, oh, maybe I like him. At first, I didn't want it to, because I was like, ugh, too complicated. When I kind of understood that he wanted to be, that he liked me too, then I was like, ugh. I guess we're gonna have to do it now. And so he said to me, oh, you must be hungry. Let's go to a restaurant. So I was like, okay, that really is a date now. If it wasn't clear before, like, that really is one. Like, we just ate together. And it was really like, obvious, like the way we were looking at each other, the way we were interacting. It wasn't any like friendly anymore. It was really like we knew it. And when we got home, I was like, okay, we still haven't kissed, and I knew it was coming, but I wanted like the right moment.
Yeah, so we were watching something on Amazon Prime, I think it was.
Both of you guys don't know what you guys watch.
I think we were both kind of in our heads, like, not really
caring about the
episode. And then when we stopped, like, we were sitting really close together, and I was like, do you want a kiss? And she was, yes.
And how was that first kiss?
What was happening? And you kind of like, ah!
And how long after this kiss did you start officially dating?
The week after. Because I already asked that night, and she wasn't sure yet, so she needed some time to think about it.
So then at some point I was like, okay, it's just like, it's stupid to be like, I don't know, like, it's obvious that I know. But I was like, no, I don't want it. I still didn't want it to tell the other roommates. Because I was overthinking it, and I was like, it's gonna be weird, it's gonna make everyone uncomfortable.
I didn't like having to be sneaky about it, or like, yeah, like act as if there wasn't anything happening.
And then I think Oisin was just sick of it, and so he was like, okay, we're dating. Like, he said it like that, Nia and I are a thing. And so I was like, oh my god, wow, it's out. No one was like, oh my god, like, that makes me so uncomfortable. No one said that, so I don't know why. I was just like, what I was so stressed about.
How did everyone react when you told them?
They all seemed like genuinely happy, so that was good. Like, yeah, they also said like they kind of expected it, or like they thought we liked each other but were afraid to tell each other.
Aww. What is your plan after you guys leave Australia? Because where do you live and where does he live?
I live in France, so I live in the suburb of Paris. And he lives in the Netherlands, in the south of the Netherlands. We're gonna try, because it's stupid to have something that good and to not try, because it's only 5-hour drive.
So what is your favorite part of them now that you know them?
Yeah, just I can talk with her about anything.
Kind-hearted. What he does is kind of genuine. Yeah, he just goes on with his life and appreciates little things.
What is the message you would like to send to your future children.
Just as long as you're not harming anyone or you're not harming yourself, do whatever you want to do.
Feel that you can always go to your parents to talk with them about anything, and they're always willing to help. I hope I, as a parent, can be the first person you go to when you have problems.
Thank you, Nia and Oshin, for sharing your beautiful love story with us. I hope you inspire many more love stories to come from all around the world.
You're welcome. Thanks for having me.
Thank you.